My name is Ingo Renner, and I'm active rather in the Typo3 community, a PHP-based content management system, quite popular, especially in the German-speaking area, but also gaining track in other regions of the world. So my lightning talk is about our integration we did with Apache Solr for Typo3, and we simply call it open source enterprise search server meets open source enterprise content management system. That would be the long version. Okay, so since quite a few international guests are here, which might not know about Typo3, as I said, it's a PHP-based content management system, and very popular here in Europe, drives sites like UNESCO.org, about 40% of German-speaking sites or sites of German companies, and yeah, some other facts in that regard. So what did we do or what offers Typo3? It's a page-based approach to content management systems. It's all centered around a page tree and offers all the features you need to build small sites, but also up to really huge sites integrating with other systems. So Typo3, of course, comes with a built-in search engine, but it's based on MySQL, and at some point, that was not good enough anymore. So what did we do? We looked around, found Apache Solr, and were very happy with that, so we started to integrate that. That was back in early 2009, and within 1 year, we set out with a goal to create a version that just acted like the integrated search engine, and that was what we achieved very easily, and even more within quite a short time. And since then, we came a long way. So there are five components we identified we needed to do the integration. Of course, you need to first index your data, search it, present it in a very flexible way, and then you, of course, want to do some index maintenance and administration, analysis, and statistics. So there are some challenges. Typo3 is used on all those sites because it's very flexible, and that caused quite some headache. It's one of the advantages, but at this point, it was rather a disadvantage to us. We needed to respect the user access restrictions, which was easy for the built-in search engine because it knew about everything. And there had been some other search integrations already, but they all didn't know about user access restrictions. Of course, we needed to index files, and since this is a PHP project, we needed to make this all work for non-Java people. And then, of course, we still needed to talk to the Apache Solr server. So what were our solutions for that? For indexing, we came up with the idea of an indexing queue. So this is basically what we do is we initialize that queue with pointers to all the content types you want to index, and it's very easy to configure what you want to index. It's basically a nice, easy to configure write down mapping of your database table fields into the index fields. And then we have a scheduler task, the scheduler is a module inside Typo3, which where you set up a cron task, and the scheduler then can run whatever task you tell it to whenever it gets called by the cron. So we have a task that runs every minute, let's say, or less frequently if you don't need it to run every minute, and then it checks what needs to be indexed. And so if an editor changes content, the record monitor takes care of recognizing the change and adding the changed element back to the index queue. And it starts from the beginning. So this is very transparent to the editor, and he doesn't need to know about everything. And it's just automatic, basically. For access restrictions, we went and wrote a custom query parser for Solr. So we added all the access restrictions into the Solr documents, and the query parser can then take care of filtering out the documents the current user is not allowed to see. He also knows about what rights the current user has, because we just simply provide those access restrictions through a GET parameter to Solr. For file indexing, we stumbled over another related Apache project, which is Apache Ticker. That's a basically content extraction tool, metadata extraction tool, and it has served us very well until now. And yeah, if you want to extract content or metadata from files, that's probably the tool to go to. It knows about 1,200 file formats and does read about half of them. Very impressive. And since we had to cater to the non-Java people, we just went and created a install script. It simply downloads a Tomcat, downloads the Apache Solr files, puts everything in the right place, downloads some Type 3 specific configuration files, schema, and so on, and also the query parser plugin. And at the end, it fires up the Tomcat, and you're ready to go. So that's very easy for everybody who wants a new, better search experience, but doesn't want to deal with the Java thing. And in the end, how do we talk to Apache Solr? That's Solr PHP client library, which we are using here. And it was basically kind of the only library that existed back then. By now, there are some other libraries, like with Zen-style configuration or even some PHP modules you can use. But I still feel very good with that library, and I think it's doing good for what we needed. So what do we have? Faceted search, of course, in all the variations. File indexing, like I mentioned, using Ticker. We can use Ticker standalone or the Ticker integrated into Solr. And we do multi-site handling, multi-language handling, spell checking, field boosting, autocomplete, all the things you would expect from a modern search engine. What are we working on? More like this is basically implemented already for a showcase, but needs to clean it up to be usable. And there are two areas or two points here: content elevation and administration of stop words, synonyms, protected words from Type 3. If you're familiar with Solr, you know those are configuration files on the Solr server. And if you're in a situation where the Solr server is on a separate machine than the web server, you can't just go and modify those files. So we are just going to try and create another plugin for the Solr server to be able to edit those files from remote. I think we are not the only ones who did that already. And yeah, spatial search or geo search is on the list too. Yeah, that's it. If you want to have a demo, just see me.